Mijn naam is Martijn Dendievel. Ik kom uit België. Ik ben heel blij van hier te mogen zijn. And because of the international jury, I will of course speak in English. Let's start with Mendelssohn, please, from the beginning.
Thank you.
Dankjewel. Thank you very much. Let's just fix some small details concerning playing together. Can we just start directly at bar 77, please? 77. Let's just have the violins and the brass just for once. So we get this ta, keta, ketam, exactly together, please, yeah? 77, violins and brass only. Just once more. I have the small impression that you're playing a little bit too fast and starting a little bit too late. Ta, ta, ketam, pam. We have to be exactly with them. Pa, keta, ketam, pam, yeah? Once more. Three. Still a little bit too late, yeah? And I know we are so few violins, I think we can hold the note a little bit longer till the end. Dee, ba 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 bum, bum, bee. And therefore, we in the winds, we have a long note, we attack, and then we take the tension out a bit so we can hear this all these 16th notes, yeah? Let's try this in tutti directly, please. 77, tutti. I think we can help if we think even more compact. Maybe not so loud, but just the intensity of the attack is all we need. Pa, katakatam, pam, pa. Don't think about playing loud. Think about the intensity, please. Yeah? Once more, same place. Much better. Marvelous, thank you. Let's go to the beginning. And can I just hear once violins, clarinets, and oboes, please, the beginning. So we find this nice sound. Yeah? Sorry to interrupt. Maybe we can try to think about gut strings. We don't have to do anything, just think about the very direct sound of gut strings. Maybe no vibrato, really intensive bow tension, and also for us when we play, just think of the old instruments, you know, small, very clear and direct sound, yeah? Even more narrow. That's it, exactly. That's wonderful. Now we get this tension. And now we, in our melody, very nervous. It's allegro, it's not some kind of andante. It should be extremely nervous from the beginning, yeah? Tutti, please, da capo. Just to save time, all the crescendos and diminuendos, I forgot to say this, start them really late, and then when we arrive at the top note, immediately go back down again. So we get this, you know, the wave against the rocks, and then again, immediately go away, yeah? Once more, please. Beginning is fantastic, thank you very much. Thank you.
versions of We Have to Go to Beethoven.
Thank you very much. Let's talk to Beethoven, please. And let's start at bar 130. That's two bars before the seconda volta. And we go to the seconda volta, please, yeah? Otherwise, we start in the middle of a phrase. Yeah, 130, and then to the second box.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. It's really great. Let's maybe jump to the beginning where we started. And let's go to 158, please. 158. I know we are so few violins, and I think, of course, it's tiring, but I would like to ask if it's possible to do it once for me, so we really stay fortissimo, and we don't let go of this note, otherwise we don't have this discussion feeling between the flutes and the violins. I mean, not only flute, also oboe. We have to really, like, kind of fight. Yes, let's not take them down, and let's really get in touch with them, yeah? We, on the other hand, we take it down a little bit, or long note, and at the very end we make a small crescendo to the next one, yeah? Let's try this, please. 158. And no compromise in the winds. Absolutely fortissimo, yeah? Sorry to interrupt, we have so little time. I think we can help the overall texture when we played all these quarter notes in the brass just a little bit more articulated, not louder, but just pop, 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 so we can hear it. I mean, it's a big hall, a lot of reverb, so let's try to focus on the clarity and not on the dynamics. Yeah? Much better. I think the crescendo can be a bit more even. To the next note, and even more, and insisting, yeah? Let's do the same place, please. 58. I think we can take a little bit of time before the piano, so we can really hear the difference. We don't do this hall, otherwise it's just impossible. Let's just take a tiny comma before the piano, and no diminuendo, otherwise we screw the joke, let's say. So don't give away the joke, really play until the last, and then just take a little bit of time with me. Let's start 6 bars before this piano. This is 206, please. 206. I think we have the same, we can do the same thing as with Mendelssohn. This forte sound, fortissimo sound, let's just less think about dynamic and playing loud. Just more about bam, bim, about the compactness of the sound. Yeah. That way the dynamic characters and the contrast will be much, much bigger. Can I ask to start at G directly? Let's just try this. I know I'm asking for a lot of energy, but every conductor has only 25 minutes, so you have to give everything, yeah? So G, and a lot of contrast, not too loud, the fortissimo, but a lot of compactness, yeah? Gustav. It's the last thing I want to try out. I think the sforzato we have there are a kind of a confirmation of the crescendo. Let's not do pa, pa, pam, pam. I think we can help if we keep the tension up until the fortissimo. Let's try again from the pianissimo, please. It's the third bar after H. Third bar after H. Thank you so much. It was a real pleasure. Bravo.